if you look at President Trump's polling and the reaction to President Trump, it's heavily driven by his style. His personal style offends a lot of Americans, and Americans want to see a change there. And so I think that Vice President Biden offers a more congenial perspective and a persona, and also his ability to work across the aisles. I do think, though, that his policies are going to alarm the financial markets, and I think that that is one of the reasons why he's talking big picture vision as opposed to specifics. I think some of the specifics, though, are going to be a tax increase, but other elements are going to be very positive for the markets, a more inclusive economy, a greater focus on addressing some of the issues that the younger generation is concerned about, like criminal justice reform and things that have led to these protests around the country. So I think that we're going to get, some things that are going to be very positive to the market, and I think some other things that are going to cause us some pause.
You know, in listening to both what you and Mr. Luntz said this morning, I wonder if Biden is a wolf in sheep's clothing, in other words, somebody who has a more radical agenda but is trying to pretend like it's not so radical and fine, or is he just a sheep? In other words, is he going to disappoint those in his party who want him to do more aggressive things by basically being, kind of the Joe Biden that we've known for the last 30 years?
I mean, first of all, Vice President Biden is a very good human being and a very honorable person. And he is going to be who he is. And I believe that has always been to the center of our party. He's been much more of a centrist in our party. And I think he'll continue to be there. I think that the people to the left, most of the activists, understand who Biden is. And they're hoping to get a few things out of him. But they see him more as a transitional president. Mm-hmm. They are totally dissatisfied with Trump. So Biden's a good alternative as a transition. And then hopefully 4 years, 8 years from now, then they get their candidate that they want, who's going to be much more to the left and kind of reorder our country.
Yeah, it will be interesting to listen for him to sketch out those details in the months ahead. If he does, if the president pushes him on that, there's still a lot, I think, to find out. Let me ask you about real estate, though, because in the meantime, some pretty dramatic headlines, Don, especially in the Wall Street Journal today, where they're saying that COVID-19 is worse for New York City real estate than either 9/11 or the financial crisis. Would you agree with that diagnosis? And what does the city do to come back from this?
Yeah, I think it's worse than both of those. And you can throw in the financial crisis of the 1970s as well. I think it's worse than all three of them. And there was an exodus out of New York prior to COVID. New York was becoming much less competitive in terms of being a business-friendly environment. It was less competitive and less attractive to high-net-worth individuals. And as a result of that, people were leaving, and they were going to Florida and other places. Companies, smaller hedge funds and private equity funds, were leaving as well. COVID accelerated that, and it showed also New Yorkers that they could work and do business outside of New York City, and they didn't have to be there. Mm-hmm. So you're going to see a massive growth in South Florida real estate. You're already seeing the Hamptons on fire. And New York City, I mean, some major projects are selling now at 50% discounts for new construction. I think that shows some real stress.
That's amazing. And there, I'm much younger than you. I don't know much, but I'm also in that kind of skeptical camp about what's going to happen to the city for all of the reasons that you've laid out. But time and again, people come back and they say, Kelly, you don't understand. People have said this about New York. You know, after these different crises for decades, the city always comes back. It is fine right now. It is going to stay fine. If real estate prices come down, you'll have a flood of new buyers. What would you say in response to that?
I would say that's extremely optimistic thinking, and we've never seen a pandemic before in the last few generations. And I think that New York will ultimately come back. It'll come back differently. It'll be a different place, and it will be much more affordable. And it's going to take quite a bit to dig out of the hole, because you have to look at New York City's politics right now, extreme to the left. So they're not focused. The political agenda is not focused on being a business-friendly environment, even quality of life. I mean, nobody walking around New York City or living in New York City can say that the quality of life has not diminished significantly. Crime is up. Those are elements and stimulus that are going to create more people leaving the city. So I think it's going to take New York about a decade or so to dig out of this, maybe longer.
Wow.
But it's not going to be soon.